Let's go back a little bit, the kidnappings. You've admitted, I've read, to involvement in the detention of activists and students in the course of your job as chief of the elite special forces, Corpasus, prior to Suharto's fall. Why was that necessary?
Well, you know, under different administrations, different policies were being carried out. I think it happens in all countries. So at that time, our overriding concern was stability. Stability, you know. And the fear was if there are destabilizing factors, we could disintegrate very fast, because we are a country of so diverse elements, so many races, so many religions, you know. And this was in the 90s, and I think that was the overriding concern of the Suharto administration.
So you pulled people in, questioned them, did you?
Yeah, so basically, you know, under one administration, it could be considered preventive detention, right? And in one aspect, you know, actually, we did prevent some of these activists. They were assembling bombs, you know. So and actually, perhaps in a different circumstance, we would be heroes. I would have got a medal or something, because my soldiers, you know, we are, our conscience is very clear. We prevented bombings. We considered that we prevented bombings and arson, you know. Under the Suharto regime, the president had extraordinary powers given by our National People's Assembly.
Okay. So you were allowed to do it.
There was emergency power. But when Suharto fell, of course, a new regime was there. What was perhaps considered legal in a former administration all of a sudden becomes illegal, and I had to be eliminated from the scene, you know. And
why?
I think they were afraid of me, you know, because I think I was very strong.
What you would do or what you would say?
What I would do, I had strong support from the combat units.
Okay.
You know, I mean, I was a combat officer. I never spent time behind a desk. My whole career was in the field. I was on operations most of the time, you know.
Were victims ever tortured?
I don't know. Some of them.
You've never ordered the torture?
I never ordered the torture at all. Completely against my policy. And I think they do realize that I never ordered the so-called kidnapping, you know, the detention. You know, but once again, I had to take responsibility. That is the duty of a commander. I refused to have my soldiers, my officers take the fall, and I faced the tribunal. I answered, you know, for because I think it was a political decision to get rid of me, actually. And I am an amateur historian. You know, I do study military history. I realize, I mean, that was what happened.
Somebody had to take the fall.
Somebody had to take a fall. Somebody had to be the scapegoat. And, well,
but then I've heard.
But then the other way, on the other side is, you know, now these guys are fighting for me, you know. You know, I always answer to some of these, you know, foreigners or Westerners who ask, I said, put this in another context. Do you think somebody who came out of Abu Ghraib would ever campaign for the American government, or somebody who got out of Guantanamo Bay would ever campaign, or, you know, would ever defend or ever fight for the American government? I mean, put it in that context. But these guys,
you have two guys who
three guys, yeah, and
former kidnapped victims or in detention,
and now
they're campaigning with you.
They're campaigning for me. Okay. They're trying to fight to make me president. You know, I mean,
because they believed what you did at the time was necessary. I mean,
no, I think they realized that I was not responsible. I was not there, and I think they knew that I actually maybe you know, I in the end I saved them, I think,
from others.
From others, yes.